River frontages drew settlers needing a reliable and plentiful supply of fresh water for stock and domestic purposes, whilst popular river crossings drew the attention of entrepreneurs. Sporadic European settlement along the Macquarie River Wambuul in the Dubbo region began in the 1820s. By 1840, two major settlements along the river had been established: Dubbo Run, owned by Englishman Robert Dalhunty, and Dundalamal, run by Scottish brothers Charles and Dalmahoy Campbell. North-south and east-west trade routes intersected the Macquarie River Wambuul at Butler's Falls, just south of Dubbo. Here the river was broad and shallow, allowing large numbers of stock to be safely herded across. The regular traffic at Butler's Falls attracted the attention of Jean Emile Sarissia and Nicholas Hieronymus, and they sought to profit from it by setting up a general store and inn on land belonging to Robert Dalhunty. Dalhunty was averse to this idea and moved them on, forcing the duo to move downstream to Dubbo's present location. The first buildings in Dubbo were a police residence and lockup, 1847, and a courthouse, 1848. Jean Emile Sarissia quickly added a general store, and Nicholas Hieronymus built the Macquarie Inn. To secure their tenure and protect their business interests, Sarissia organized a successful petition to the government to lay out allotments for purchase and create a township. Dubbo was subsequently proclaimed a village in 1849. One of the advantages of Dubbo's location was the nearby bed of sandstone on the west bank of the Macquarie River Wambuul, in the park now known as Sir Roden Cutler Park, and in the area near Stonehaven Avenue, which was named after the quarry. The sandstone was quarried to produce building material for many of Dubbo's important buildings, including the first bank in Dubbo, the Commercial Bank, 1865, in Macquarie Street, the Holy Trinity Anglican Church, 1875, in Brisbane Street, and the Railway Station Master's Residence, 1881. The lack of a convenient method of crossing the Macquarie River Wambuul remained a drawback to the development of Dubbo until 1866, when the first bridge, the White Bridge, was built. The White Bridge replaced the punt that had previously transported passengers and supplies across the river. 6 years later, in 1872, Dubbo became part of a newly created municipality, and James Samuels Jr. was elected as the first mayor. Dubbo's importance as an economic centre increased further when the railway linking Dubbo to Sydney was completed in 1881. The magnificent new railway infrastructure included the bridge over the Macquarie River Wambuul, which survives today. The White Bridge was rebuilt in 1905, and this bridge was eventually replaced by the L.H. Ford Bridge, the first bridge in New South Wales to incorporate a roadway with a spiral curve, opening to traffic in 1969. In 1987, traffic congestion on the L.H. Ford Bridge was relieved by the building of a second road vehicle bridge, the Jean Emile Sarissia Bridge, named in honour of Dubbo's founding father,